Well, welcome to episode 22 of FPL Top Dogs, Ballyhaunis, and just a quick roundup of what's been going on. I haven't had an episode 20, well, game week 21. I was in Ireland. I haven't had done nothing since the 13th of January. I was back in Ireland at the time and just didn't get into any sort of mood to cover an episode back home or do anything with the guys. Basically the big news of game week 22, because on the 14th there was a game week 22, 14th of January, so I got a quick one in on the 13th. But basically Joey Neenan took over the show here with Captain Fernandez. He scored twice, I think, Villa, yeah, and then two assists against Brentford. So he stole a match and loads of us, I think a lot of us had Captain Salah and loads of others, and we just overlooked Fernandez, and that's a 46 clean points. I think the best people got really that game week was around 70-ish. So the whole league was absolutely totally goosed. So what we done after that was that was game week 22. Game week 23 just gone was another massively long one. It just went on forever. We just had on the 5th of February, the 0-0 against Burnley and Watford. So that was going on since Friday the 21st to the 5th. So big game week there. So where are we now? So I have the life, I have everything. The price changes anyway. Nothing going on really. Price Jack, I don't think anyone would be going for him. Laporte is just nearly a must have at this stage if you want to sit your defender. But everybody else has been going down. And Quebec and Adam Armstrong's gone down. Bowen's gone up. So I'm watching out for Mo Salah, really. I want to get him in before everybody else is thinking about getting him in. But he's playing tonight in the African Nations. Again, going on here. Still 0-0 with AFC Bournemouth and Bournemouth. So that won't affect what will go on in game week 30. None of the Premier League teams drew each other, apart from Southampton and West Ham. So this is going to affect game week 30. Because we expect most of the teams to, the Premier League teams to go through on the fifth FA Cup round fourth round being played. So here we go. The quarter. So the second of March is. I have the fifth because there was a mistake in another article. Wednesday the second. So on the fifth and sixth, there's the Premier League. So the quarterfinals on the 19th, and that's game week 30 that everyone has to keep an eye out for. So have we got any? That's the Emirates. So I'm looking for the draw. I have everything higgledy piggledy all over the place here. I'll have to go solo. Where's the draw? I've got no draw. I'll just have to go by memory here. Okay, so of course, like game week 27 is the blank game week that people have to keep an eye out for. Arsenal Wolves. So there's a double game. Yeah, there's a double game week, but this is not so much of a blank game week, really. I don't know why people. There's only Chelsea players not in there. No Chelsea and Arsenal. So I wouldn't mind too much about 27. Everyone should have enough players for that one. It's game week 30 that's the problem that we need to keep aware of. The Wolves Leeds match is going to be on because they're both out. Aston Villa and Arsenal will both be on. Because they're both out of the FA Cup. Leicester were knocked out tonight 4-1 away to Nottingham Forest. So they're out. So that Brentford game will go ahead. And there's a possibility that Burnley and Southampton will go ahead. Because that's only if West Ham knock out Southampton. But, you know, Tottenham have got a tricky one away to Middlesbrough. Of course, if Middlesbrough knock out Tottenham and if Southampton beat West Ham, then the Spurs-West Ham game will go ahead. So there's a couple of things in the air. If I had the fixture, the list of... maybe it will just show me FA... FA Cup. Maybe it will show me the whole... Third round, so it won't. I had it up and I totally messed up here. I got rid of the draw yet. So this is the 18th. This is game week 30. I know that. So Liverpool, who have they got? I can't think who Liverpool got. Let's see. FA. Yeah, I had all these all up and I've video, folks. Apologies. Fifth round raw details. I just go to this one here. I had it up before. This is the one I had up before. Chelsea, come on. It's Chelsea. Chelsea, they're going to go through to game week 30, so they should be off. You know, Palace, you think, will they beat Stoke? Maybe, possibly. Who knows? But if Palace don't do it, then who have they got? All right, that's Kieran's thing. It's not really working out tonight, guys. So Palace, Newcastle. No, are Newcastle still in? Newcastle's still in the cup. Don't see Newcastle in there. So obviously, if Stoke beat Palace, Newcastle are in there. So there's a few ifs and buts here. Liverpool, Norwich. Well, it's Liverpool. They should go through. So that's the Southampton, West Ham. Forest is not affected. Everton, Bournemouth, or Bournemouth. So those teams. So it's a bit ifs and buts, but just to be aware, most of the top teams will go through, and we know for a fact. We know for a fact Villa and Arsenal, Leicester and Brentford, the other one on top, Wolves and Leeds will go through. You know, if Spurs get through Borough, then that match will go through. If Southampton beat West Ham, but if West Ham beat Southampton away in the cup in the fifth round, then if Southampton beat West Ham, then the Spurs match will go ahead. So it's ifs and buts, but it's hard to know yet. After game week 28, everybody will tighten up a bit more. So still to plan for this, we don't know. What else is there? Well, this game week 23 just gone. It's looking really, really bad there until Trippier came in for my guy Loughton. And unfortunately, Pope on the bench. Oh my God. I had put him on the bench because I thought Burnley are going to concede against Arsenal. And there you go. There you go. That's what happens. Man of the match performance from Popey. I have Popey in. Loughton's a mistake. He's not getting game time. There's a guy called Roberts at right back taking his place. Doesn't look like he'll get a chance. So I want to get rid of him. I'm going to let things go for a couple of game weeks to get two transfers and then get Salah in. You know, everyone's wondering, you know, Salah's going to be coming back. See, Liverpool don't have to play until Thursday, the 10th, and that would give Salah about 4 days to rest. There's a possibility he could be on the bench for Leicester. So if I let, you know, I've got a transfer, if I let that one go, then I can earmark him for game week 25 because I'll have two transfers by then. So I think I'll get in Salah in for that one. So the 7 points. Well, Foster's got his clean sheet, but he got no saves. I'm sure he made saves in that game, but it could have been worse, you know. Burnley should have and could have scored one or 2 points for Foster. And Loughton May came on as a sub, 1 point. So 13 points is better than nothing. And in this game week, it was a total disaster in a way. And King got booked as well, which is just typical, isn't it? Dennis, massive mistake there, probably in a temper after not going to African Nations Cup. I don't know where his brain is at, but King got booked. That's brilliant. Only 1 point from him. Watford should have the penalty as well in the first half. Can't believe a handball, but there you go. It's just some results just seem to be, we're going to have a nil-niler for that. So that was 14 points. So sitting on 24 Sitting on 23 points, must have been 23 points. That I was nearly 500,000, so I made some space up. But it's not really about me. This show, I'm going to go into a bit more later. What am I going to do? I'm just going to sit at the moment, and Yeah, use the wild card just in a huff. Just there was a lot of injuries and transfers, and with the wild card, I'm happy enough with what I've done. I'm happy with Trippier. Newcastle will get games. I'm a bit worried now. Gutierrez has come in for Newcastle, and obviously Wood. So who knows? So Maximum mightn't be a starter. At least there could be a rotation thing there. Happy enough with De Bruyne. I know that most people don't have him, so I'm going to just try my luck with him. Fernandez, I probably will get rid. United are just in no sort of form. Now with Greenwood's issue now, with the accusations, that it's not a happy camp. Ronaldo missing the penalty now against Middlesbrough. And I don't know how they didn't win that game. And there's a lot of downside to United at the minute. I think not having Jota for a couple of weeks, not having Salah, Jota will be fine. Hopefully he'll cover. But then again, now with Luis Diaz, whatever, him coming in now, Firmino and Jota could be in trouble for starts. We'll have to see. Yeah, so that's enough of that. What I want to do is get the live FPL and get this thing up. I had it up, and usually give a roundup of where everybody is. Well, I've already stated that Joey Commando Neenan is just destroying us. And what do you expect? Really, really spanking us this year. I suppose we are small fry at the moment. Stephen Strett was pushing a bit. He did take the lead a while back. But that Fernandez move blew us out of the water, and I just don't know how you're going to make that guy. I'm about 130 odd points back from Joey, and it's just maybe I'm just getting a bit too old for this game. There is an age limit, I suppose. Just probably not willing to go with the standard following people and seeing what they're doing. I just want to do my own thing and do it my way, and that doesn't get me the results. So there's Joey. So he took out Tony for King. He's 1,452. Well ahead there, 28 points ahead of Stephen Strett for Nolan. It's not all done and dusted there. Connor Hussey has been phenomenal this season coming in and, doing what he's doing. Bella Locke, lad. So he's still in with the shout. So is Morgan Lyons. He's been hanging in very, very gritty. And Fergie Walsh has gone back a lot from where he was leading for maybe 14 game weeks for most of the season, but the wild card, like myself, very disappointing. But I'm just going to trust what I've done, what I was doing, but it changes every minute depending if you got two free hits left or you've got the wild card and a triple captain in the bench boost. Well then, my god, good luck. Yeah, so Starman's made a great move as well. Captain Fernandez, terrific. He had him that game week as well with Joey. The rest of us, I think, we're on Salah. This is the game week. Kieran Kiley hanging in there. Myself, 13.37. Quite a bit back, so that's 15. So 115 points. I'm not crying. I'm just going to... Still an awful long way to fourth, the trophy position. Going to be tough to make back them 50 points. Have to take some risks. Top 10 will be open again for maybe some hats. Or I figure I have to get the bloody hats from last season. So if they will come, folks. They're already in my wife's luggage ready, guys. Oracle now, he wants to overtake me as quick as he can and move onwards. I know how he feels. I'm trying to do that with Kieran Kiley and the rest. Not going to call it a day. It did feel like deleting the whole thing, though. I seriously felt, especially after Dennis got sent off, captaining them as well. That's just ruin anyone's day. Jerry Freely, myself, Sean Gilday, David Martin, just a bit further back. Yeah, most of these, Kevin Kilbride, even back down there, is there a chance to get... It's hard to know, really. I think when you're in our sort of range, my range down to David McNamara, maybe Keith Robinson. You're looking at, can I get a top 200,000 finish? Well, that's all I'm looking at. There's nothing else to play for at the minute, not until I get closer to these guys. They're kind of a bit too good to be given a 50-point lead at this stage. But yeah, it's all about to win the Christy Nicholson. It's going to take a lot of doing to catch Joey. He's making good decisions. You won't be happy with this game week. Just gone. Nobody will be happy. It was just damn squib. Again, Captain and Dennis like myself. And I got in, I took a -4 or something. No, I did my wild card to get King in as well. That was a mistake. I got rid of somebody anyway. Let's see, Foster. Tripling up in Watford, yeah. So I think I think Arsenal have a double blank game week coming up. And Chelsea are blanking as well. So you're just going to have to sit down and just figure out. There's too many variables to kind of figure out a clear plan. Every team has got different issues. So this game week, there's no Chelsea. There's a double game week. This is where, you know, Arsenal blank, yeah. So I'm just going to sit back and just see what to do with this. Pick your team. Well, I'm just going to leave it as it is, more or less. Game week 24. Yeah. Yeah, what else is there to say? Yeah, King of the Travelers. 54 for Kieran Kiley, still leading out there with Connor Hussey. A trophy up for this one. Jerry Feeney's still hanging in there. He can still win it. Owen Collins and Sean Gilday, they're the ones that can still have a chance, but it will be tough to take out Kieran Kiley. You know, game week 24, is it now? Game week 24, and there's only like 14 game weeks left. So there's not much time to catch Joey at the top in the Christy Nicholson and to catch Kieran Kiley in this one. Yeah. And I don't really fancy too much of a chance over here. Those two draws really stopped me anyway. And that's it. Bit of a downer with the whole thing. Just not a lot to play for. Doing better in the Sundream team. So there's not much really to add on here too much. Oh, yeah, I just wanted to show. Get there. Yeah, so anybody who's not from Ballyhaunis, this is where we are located here. And I do a rough synopsis of the Premier League FPL here in Ireland. And obviously, this is Ireland here. That's where we're located in Ballyhaunis and FPL Top Dogs. The Ballyhaunis area. Most of our players are from like Knock. You know, that's a Clonfad, Dunmore, Castlereagh, you know, Charlestown, Kilkelly. You need to go in a bit more for Torin and more of the local area. But like in our area, there's some really good quality players in the Christy Nicholson League. So that's why I want to do this thing is to highlight that we're not doing too bad. And I want to take in, you know, Loughlin and a few of the friends, you know, it's a nice little. And going down to Galway as well, as you can see. Galway's more of a Ballantyne here. So, you know, we have players out there. This Mayo, Irish Town, and Milltown, that's Galway. So, yeah, that's what I want to kind of highlight there, where FPL Top Dogs is located. This is where you can catch the videos. Yep. Let's see now. Yeah, so there you go. Vince Wega, FPL Top Dogs. And we're just simply looking at Joey's team anyway. He's got a lot of Chelsea. So maybe he can put him on the bench. But all the time, their prices keeps dropping, doesn't it? Like, everyone is... Well, I haven't seen too many drops for Chelsea. So I think most of the damage has been done anyway. It's only a couple of games. Cancelo, Bernardo, yeah. City. No double game week. They're out. Don't like Watford. They are a liability. So Joey has a bit of thinking to do here. Rafinha is very good. No Burnley in there. I like Burnley. I'm going to stock up on them. I don't like the look of Weghorst anyway. Another possibility, obviously, you know, Digne has now transferred over from Everton, as everybody knows. He's a great option as well. Very interesting. But I went for Trippier. I couldn't get both. Yeah, Fernandez. You see, he's got to fit in Salah somehow. And there's a lot of figgling about every game week. Up to game week 27, game week 24. They say it's a blank, but it's the next one. I think it's Brighton, isn't it? So Chelsea and Brighton don't have a game this week. So if you've got many Chelsea and Brighton, you're in trouble a little bit. Chelsea will miss the next two game weeks, this one as well. All right. Brighton are back. Brighton have a double game week with United. So you want to be keeping all your United and Brighton players anyway. See if you can survive this game week with your Brighton and Chelsea. And as you know, he's got two Chelsea. I don't see is any Brighton. No. So he can survive it. But there's a lot of, I still think, who am I to say he's having a phenomenal season? But there's a lot of work to do there, actually. Not many of them have double game weeks. Well, like, there's no Tottenham in there. I have to figure out what I have to do myself. I got two transfers anyway. The eye test there, I think Joey's got a bit of work to do over the next 6 weeks are going to be crucial. But I think maybe he can free hit. He's probably got two of them left. Is this my one or his one? My one. Just going to do a quick eye test of the other team. Stephen Nolan. Okay, he's got no Brighton. He's laughing there. He's got rid of his Chelsea ages ago. Still West Ham. Gerhard doesn't play much. I don't think Reguilon gets two games in a row. I think his minutes gets managed too often for me. I don't like him. I like him when he plays. Come on, you Spurs. But Ramsdale will be good, and Foster. So he can alternate with Ramsdale because Foster seems to be given the Roy Hodgesource. Hodgson has gone to Watford after Ranieri was sacked after the abysmal performance away at home to Norwich, which was absolutely shocking. I'm just shocked with that game. I had nightmares of that game with Dennis getting sent off. It was a really great day, great crack. I had great time in Christy Nicholson's and Ballyhaunis. Spent most of the day there, had a few bets and won them. And then that result totally, my God. Gray now is, they've changed the system now with Lampard. He's gone like 3-4-3. So the two wide players are kind of ancillary back four and a four. Well, how was it? A three? Two. What am I talking about? It must be a 4-3-3 or some sort of that suits Gray more. What am I talking about? Gray anyway could be good. Keen. Plenty of games in there. Eye test, fine. It's okay. It's okay. Connor Ossie, De Gea, good. Double game week coming up. Yeah, Stephen Strett here. He's got one United, but it's probably Fernandez the only one I keep just for that double game week if I can. and then get rid of him for Salah in. And let's say, so this is the double game week 25. Yeah, keep him. See, I can't get rid of Fernandez to get in Salah when he's got a double game week. So what can you do? I'm goose there. So I'm gonna have to let Salah go for a couple and then take the punishment with the transfers. Oh, talk about working this shit out. Sorry for my language. It's adult though, adult show. And now Kane is an option. Oh my God, Kane is an option. I made a mistake with the wild card. I'm just going to have to fess that one up. De Bruyne and Fernandez, then get rid of them two for Kane and Salah. I don't know. I want to keep De Bruyne. Maybe I've got some in the bank just to get rid of De Bruyne quickly, get Salah in. I have enough in the bank just to do a straight swap that week and keep Fernandez. So I think that's what I'll do. Who have City got to play? Norwich away. Oh, no. Burnley might actually do a job on Liverpool. I might just leave Liverpool. I prefer De Bruyne. Probably caps Fernandez. I don't know the penalty situation. It's a total joke at United. Seriously. Fernandez was scoring them, and now Ronaldo's missing them. So I think the answer is to do nothing. And on this game week, that's what I'm going to do. Burnley. Ooh, I forgot. Watford have got Brighton, so I'll have Foster in there for Brighton and again take Pope out of the light, out of fire line. But then you might guess Pope is great against the top teams. Do you dare rest Pope? That's the question. So yeah, that's, I've worked out what I'm doing there. Obviously, this is just all raw. Yeah, so Connor Hussey or Ballyhaunis CBS X Ballinlock dude. Good guy, all round gent. Yeah, keep the United. Yeah, Liverpool, fine. He's got Robertson in. That's a great move. He's well on it. He's ahead of the curve here. Obviously, with De Bruyne. So I'm not going to make anthem with him on De Bruyne. There you go. Terrific. Madison, not sure. So Dele off there. I'd keep just in case for the double game week. Okay, the only crack with him here is Sanchez, but De Gea will play for game of 24 coming. He's got no Chelsea, so I think he's in a great situation. He just needs Foden to do something. He's got all in on Liverpool and City there, and neither of them three have a lot of double game weeks coming up. Liverpool might get a double game week later on. Yeah, I really like the look of Connor's team. I think it's phenomenal. I think it's phenomenal. Son against Foden to get in Robertson for Johnson. Fair enough. Good move. That worked out. What's Morgan been at? It's probably half time now in that African Nations. Morgan. Okay, he's got a lot of Brighton for next week. No Chelsea, fair enough. He's got Gallagher will come on. He's got Kane. I don't think he's got much problem for this game week. Looking at it, they'll all do a good job for him. Going forward, no United. And I know Brighton have a double game week. So United will be a risk to Morgan if he doesn't do something about it. He's got plenty of money in the bank anyway, getting rid of Lukaku for Dennis. And again, he caught in that Dennis trap like myself and Joey Neenan. And King didn't do much for the other top two. Yeah, so I like the look of Connor's team the best. Fergie Walsh, what's been going on there? He's done the wild card. Going forward, Ramsey. Okay, Fernandez, fair enough. I'm going to try to keep Jota for as long as I can and see if he can counteract what Salah does. It's a risk. Cucurella, okay, fair enough, going forward. He won't play. But yeah, this game week, he looks fine. He's got Kane in, which is fine. It's impossible to get Kane, De Bruyne, Salah, and Fernandez to get them four in your team to have any sort of solid team going forward. Kilman's handy to have. Wolves will have a double game week. But Hydra now, he's out with a hernia, so nobody knows when he'll be back. Could be a month. And Weghorst is in now. Loughton doesn't play. Robertson's been taking his spot. So Fergie's got a lot to think about. The Burnley. I was looking at Burnley dudes myself, you know, just to get a few more in. So because I know they're going to have loads of games. But I have to get rid of Loughton and do something. I'll be messing about. I think Newcastle will have a couple of good games. They've got Everton next, I think. So I'll definitely be looking for something out of Newcastle this game week. Yeah, we can't forget about the star man who's been rocketing up the table. A great score for the week game week that was in it. 49, 50s. Phenomenal. Getting in Dini as well. You know, very, very good move. But he's on the bench, unfortunately, for him. What can you do? Tierney's an Arsenal fan. So, you know, that's 4 points. Look, Laporte is a great move again. Diaz seems to be dropped every other game. Nobody knows. He seems to be alternating a bit. Akai seems to be getting more game time. If you bring in Dina, I would be playing him. I don't care who. If he's good enough to bring in like that, play him. And then I bring Trippier in, and I don't play him, but he came on as a sub. Thank God. Sterling. Nobody knows if he's going to be rested for either our cup game, Champions League. It's just have no idea if he's going to be playing. And also, City don't have many double game weeks compared to some others like Spurs and Burnley and Newcastle and Villa. Mount, he'll be missing. Dino will come in. Could do bits and pieces. But going forward, he could get away this week without doing much and then start planning for how to get Salah back. Kieran Kiley, the eye test is very good. He's just on it all the time. Look, Dennis, easy thing to do. Easy thing. But taking De Bruyne, I think he only had to get one game week, getting two assists. So that was very good. Great move for him there. Rudiger, okay. So, yeah, not many of the guys have any trouble for the game week coming up. No Brighton and Chelsea. You know, with Arsenal blanking a couple of games and then in between they have the double game week. So the possibility of free hitting for that double game week. Which one is it now? Yeah, Arsenal have the game there against Brentford and Wolves. Yeah, I was thinking Arsenal don't have a game. What did they have a game? Yeah, they don't have a game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, so the Arsenal and Chelsea game was the one that was taken off. So the Arsenal don't have a game this game week. Sorry, 24 they do. So fair enough. Arsenal there are fine there against Wolves. But, you know, then they don't have a game week in 25. That's when you want your United and Brighton. They have a double game week, which are really good games anyway. Brentford and Wolves. But then again, you can't predict anything. And they have no game here. So it's really tricky. People will just decide what to do to the free hits and whatever. So yeah, Kieran Kiley, I love the look of the team. Kane's fine. Again, he'll have to make a decision. You know, he's got no Jota, no Salah. And no Mane. Liverpool will be a liability to him a bit there. Cody is okay. He'll have double game weeks. Okay, Rudiger not playing, but I'd keep him if you. But not much on the bench. So can you keep him? Can you afford to keep him? Because it's going to be two game weeks, he's missing him. And no, nothing really on the bench. So it's just, I keep Brownell anyway, because he's Burnley and he gets a couple of points, but it's not going to be that not that interesting. It's hard to know going forward. This is going to be a make or break two or three or four game weeks coming. You make a move for one game week and you're goosed for the next one. So it's going to be just a tactical nightmare coming. And I advise you to watch all the other dudes now, like, you know, Let's Talk FPL and FPL Mate and FPL Scout as well. They'll advise you better than myself. Marky Oracle Phillips, United, fine. Okay, cancel, you need him. Bit of Chelsea and the Bastille won't be playing. So very De Gea reliant. Mount and Rudiger aren't playing. Lacazette, that can be an issue with the two. You know, obviously, you could captain them for that double game week in 26 for Arsenal, but nothing either side. Coutinho, done well the other day, so oh, it's really hard to know. Marky, again, sit down and analyse it. Yeah, you got to be United anyway for that double game week, game week 25 for United and Burnley, or is it? Yeah, game week 25. Surely Fernandez is the man there to be on. But don't know Marky. The other dudes, Jerry. Okay. It's a mixed bag here with Jerry, isn't it? Okay, Foster will come on for Sanchez. Okay, it's a mix of everything, isn't it? It's, Watkins has not been doing it. Gallagher is hot and cold. Gray might be something now, more under Frank Lampard. But yeah, Benitez is unlucky with DCL and Rick Harrison being suspended and bits of injuries. Yeah. Oh, it's a frustration. The sniper Gilday. Against, I don't like Mora. He's okay, but I don't know when he starts. He seems to be his minutes are managed. Okay, Mount, fair enough. Duffy should be gone ages ago. Sanchez won't be playing, so Mount won't be playing. There's a few bits of issues there. Yeah. It's Foden. It's hard to know really. Not many people have brought any of the new signings in from other clubs, so that's more or less all you can say about that. So that's where we are. Joey Neenan now, anyway, leading by a country mile. A big gap down to the top, well, down to the sixth place there, especially myself down in eighth. And we'll know more, and we're just going to have to figure out in the long run whose strategy works the best. And how many chips do you use at Rice? And I think we can safely say now the COVID times here now are past us. A lot of games to rearrange and coming in the future. Kind of a bit more stability now and being certain of our fixtures. What's the latest of the sports here? Nearly an hour gone in this. I didn't mean to take you for an hour. Bournemouth taking out Bournemouth. Wow, that's crazy. I think the winner of that plays Everton in the next round. Still 0-0. So this is a good time for myself now to get off here. And that's all I can say, folks. Sorry I missed the episode there the other day, back in Ireland. And wanted some sort of roundup. That was the weekend Joey got the double of the captain on Fernandez and Starman. So, you know, Bula Bus for the $2, you know, and they're really leading the way there. Actually, you didn't check to see where Joey's in the world. That would be interesting. I think the best way to do it is to use our Ballyhaunis town player here in the town. I think he mainly plays down the left wing a lot. That's mainly his position, a winger. Can play in midfield. So where is Joey? The Ballyhaunis pups. He's 1,452. So he's on course to get to his rightful position. Is he? Oh, that's his points. Oh, I'm sick. 32,986. Sorry. As you get older after, you know, your brain starts to turn off here, but 32,900. So 30, just under 33,000 out of nearly 9 million players. So that's the crack we have there with Joey. He's in striking zone anyway. And if he plays his cards right, obviously, he, you know, I feel he will. He's very, you know, hard on himself with certain things. So he's still got the wild card, the free hit, the bench boost, and the triple cap. So he's in a good position there. Most of everyone did that well, that free hit there. Good time. A lot of people reckon it's best to do your free hit when you've got, you know, only one or two games missing. And you can, as most of the better teams are playing, and you can, you know, I prefer it the other way around. I prefer to only like three or four you use it. But you can plot and plan now. I just don't think game week 27 is all that frightening coming up. You can kind of plan for it. Obviously, there's no Arsenal. Again, there's no Chelsea. Okay. I just don't know if I bother with Chelsea and Arsenal, even though they have that double game week in 20 and game week 26. Again, I think it will be time to be getting definitely Harry Kane in. I just like the cut of him, especially now against Brighton in the FA Cup. That goal, the first goal, oh my God. I'll be thinking that. I'd definitely be thinking of that. Burnley's fine. United, Watford. I don't think what Fernandez, if you have him, is, or any United players, is a time to get rid of them. Although maybe the defense, yeah, but the only guy I have in United is Fernandez. I think that Ronaldo's become a bit of an issue. He's one paced and he just hangs up goal up all day. Well, if you're playing against Middlesbrough, you think you have no threat, you just could just stay. It's not, you know, it's just stay up front, you know. I think they're unlucky that day. Sancho off the bar, scored another day. They could have been 4-0 by halftime. Yeah, so yeah, I just don't think game week 27 is all to be worth from my position anyway. And that's where we'll leave for that. So I'm just gonna look for a top 200k, make sure I get over the 2,000 points anyway. And that's why I'm here, American, and see where that and finishes it. And that would be a good season for myself. And anybody else in my situation in the league here, the same kind of goes for you. Yeah. Yeah, anyone 137. Yes, anyone down to Kevin Guru, Kevin the Guru Killer. Oh yeah, I forgot. Yeah, that's a good thing. Just want to indicate that I'm not totally useless when it comes to the King of the Travelers. It looks like the Guru Killer was taken out by the Guru, so I just want to highlight that, folks. That if the Guru Killer is watching, you know, if Kevin, you know, you've been done there, unfortunately, you know. There's only one Guru. Yeah, now Richardson took out Stephen from the gem. Han Solo took out Connor Hussey. Big defeat that for Connor Hussey. How did Kieran, aka 47 Kylie, do? He's taken out by Joey. So there was no zero sum game between the two, Connor and Kylie, so that's a little bit back. Yeah, so we caught up a bit. Yeah, what's the snowman doing? He says he's given up on this quickly. The snow, okay, Sanchez, fair enough. Double game will come in, Foster will come in. The bench is looks very haggard, very old-fashioned at this stage. You know, Kane, fair enough. Antonio, good. He's got... Captain Salah, okay, fair enough. the good point with Christy, he's on Salah straight away. He can steal a march on a lot of us that way. well, Diaz now, it looks like Laporte. I'd get rid of them too, just for Laporte. Medico has been very well this season. I thought he's Manquillo. I still think there's, I know where he's coming from. He's still got a lot to play for. Look at that. He's got a wild card, two free hits, a bench boost, and a triple captain. Are you joking me? I think he can still make the top 10 if you're listening to me. A man of your experience, bud. Did anybody lose to the average, though? Yeah, that's okay. So, Starman, bet the average there. So that's about that then. Owen Collins, a great win. Great 52 points there. Looks like he's got the... Well, Desert Duffy got the best one. Yeah, fair enough. Okay, folks, that's all. I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching, guys. Give me a like and a subscribe if you like my ranting and raving. Been out of practice with this for a while. Maybe get a video on it for next week done. Game week is starting on Tuesday. I've got rid of everything, but it's on Tuesday, starting on Tuesday, Wednesday, and then Thursday is Liverpool match. Possibility that Salah would be back. I think they're playing Leicester. So, yeah, so it's Sunday now. So good luck, God bless, and thanks for watching, guys, especially if you stay till the end. You must be absolutely mad, but there you go. FPL Top Dogs out. God bless. Sayonara.